free gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Paul said, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." John 3:16, the gospel in a nutshell, makes it very clear that God so loved the world, the meaning of Christmas, that he gave his uniquely born Son, the virgin birth of Jesus Christ, his sinless, perfect life as the eternal Son of God, true and sinless humanity, qualified him to die upon the cross for the sins of the entire human race. Whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Jesus Christ himself made it very clear when he said, "I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man comes unto the Father except through me." So Melanie and John have come to the Father through Jesus Christ. They have personally received him as their Savior. That is the most important decision that we can make in life. It is that one instantaneous decision that seals our eternal destiny, qualifying us to live with God forever. And I know that I not only speak for myself, but for the bride in the room and for their families, to encourage each one of you, if you've never made this the most important decision in life, to do so, and you can do it right now, simply by telling God that you are believing that Jesus Christ is your Savior, that you are personally trusting him for salvation. And after that, the most important decision that any individual can make, the second most important decision, is to grow in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, which is the regular, consistent intake of Bible doctrine, the principles, the teachings, the concepts of the Word of God, as Spirit-filled believers, to metabolize this vital truth in our souls and to obey it, to live it out to the glory of God. Because this kind of spiritual growth through the Word of God is what enables a young man and a young woman to make the identification signals that they are right man, right woman, designed for one another by God in eternity past. And to come together today to make the third most important decision in life, that is the decision of matrimony. Entering into this divine institution ordained by God for the expression of virtue, love, and for the expression of affection and discipline and everything that is necessary to train up children and to have families on these wonderful traditional American values that has caused this nation to be the greatest nation in all of human history. And so divine revelation in the Word of God has declared marriage to be completely honorable. It is an institution of God, ordained in the time of man's innocency, before he had sinned against his Maker and been yet banished from paradise. It was given in wisdom and in grace to repress irregular affection, to support social order, and to provide that through well-ordered families, truth and holiness might be transmitted from one age to another. Earlier, therefore, than all laws of merely human origin, it lies at the basis of all human legislation and civil government, and the peace and well-being of our beloved nation I once thought marriage took just two to make it go, but now I am convinced it takes the Lord also. And not one marriage failed, for Christ is asked to enter as lovers come together with Jesus Christ as the center. But marriage seldom thrives, and homes are incomplete till he is welcomed there joining their hands,